Hey!
Hey, we're playing a game. Ren and Stimpy presents Stimpy's Invention. God damn. I don't know where to start, really. I mean, I remember watching Ren and Stimpy when I was little. And I remember loving it a lot. Normal. I remember loving it a lot. Special attack jumper. Whoops. Remember loving it a lot. So, naturally, seeing that there is a video game for it is even better. And I know I've already played this once on the channel, but not as a Let's Long Play. And I know this game quite well, so I don't have to practice. Played it a lot when I was little. Saw it being played a lot because we were all Ren and Stimpy fans in the house. And like you say, when you see a video game for a franchise you like, you wanna buy it. As a video game, an interactive piece of entertainment, it's pretty basic. Like, its platforming elements are pretty normal. Its special abilities and stuff like that are pretty, you know, normal stuff you can do like that. There are a few gimmicks in some levels. You know, it's generic. So I'd imagine, really, the only people who would get a kick out of this game are Ren and Stimpy fans. Pretty much. I mean, I wouldn't recommend this to anybody if they weren't Ren and Stimpy fans. Because this game is also chock full of references. Okay, let's jump. Special. Okay. Yeah. You can do different stuff as well. Alright, let's go over here. If I just press the buttons by themselves, C, B, A. But I know if I press up and C. Yeah, up and C, that does that. Down C does nothing. Left C, just, you know, jump. I think down in B? Bowling, up and B. Get to do that with a nose. Up and A, you get to slap Stimpy. Down in A, you get to do something like that. But like I say, if it's left and right, you just normal stuff. Oh, and if you hold A, you get to run. So yeah, that's the controls, really. And the rest is pretty basic. Hold on. There. It's pretty basic. I mean, I don't know what else to say. And you can get health back by getting items. But I'm not sure which items, though. I don't remember which one. Perhaps that. We'll see. Nope. But you can get points. Ice cream, maybe? Nope. I know you get points from pretty much everything, but I'm not sure about health. But yeah, you get a lot of chances. But yeah, if there's any Ren and Stimpy fans out there, there you go, that's health. It's like, we're the episode of the horse. See, the horse is right there. Remember that episode? If anybody used to watch that show, they'd open the door and the horse would be there and he'd say something creepy. Oh, whatever. These things from, is that the nature episode? I can't remember if it's the nature episode or the episode where they're in space. But they're a lot smaller here. I remember in the episode they were a lot bigger. See, and it's pretty easy, this game, really. Well, it's easy for me because I know it quite well. So I don't know what to say. Whoops. Ah, ice creams. Get it? Ice cream. Fucking puns, yo. Also, there's powdered toast man. If you or Stimpy fall out of bounds or something, and you get brought back, because you don't die instantly, you lose health and come back. You die when you run out of health. But if you fall out of bounds, powdered toast man comes in and saves you. and says something like that, like, leave everything to me! Or there'd just be a generic fanfare, like, some nonsense. This game really is just chaos. It's what it is. Oh wait, I don't need to do that. Alright, this is where the down and A comes in handy. Oh! Alright, I gotta... There we go. And that's one piece of the machine. Oh yeah, if anybody wasn't paying attention to the start bit, Stimpy made a machine called the Mutant-O-Matic, and he tried to turn it on and it exploded. And we gotta go get all the pieces back, and we just got Beaver Power, which is also another reference to the cartoon. Because sometimes in between the main skits of the animations, the creators would make piss-take adverts of other adverts like Dog Water or Beaver Power or the log, because everybody loves a log or some nonsense. So yeah, that's a reference to that. Like I say, this game is chock full of Ren and Stimpy references, so there's no... Oh god, that was not well timed at all. There we go. I think you gotta keep going here, because I think these guys do eventually end up disappearing, so you gotta... There we go. Come on, Stimp, I need you. There we go. There we are. There we go. Three. Down B, there we go. Good, good, good. Where do I go here? Is this the end of it? Yeah, it is. Awesome. Also, giraffes look pretty harmless, don't they? Let me get a bit closer. Looking vicious! Alright, I think the way to get over these is this. You gotta... Oh! Timed it wrong. But yeah, that's the way to do it. Position it just right so you can Stimpy fart over the lot. Ah! Oh, and some life, good. Also, another episode reference in here. Remember the episode where they go into the zoo? Because they want to get fed for free, because that's what they're looking for. They're looking for food. And they see... Oh god, they're in the zoo, and they see that they're getting the gorillas and all that, and the chimps are getting free food. So that's their deal, really. They get given free food, so they break in, pretend to be animals, and get given free food. I think they give up the goose, though, because of a particular part of the ep where... Oh, no, wait. I've remembered the episode all wrong. They see that people of the public are giving chimps like free food, like cake and sandwiches and stuff like that. And Ren and Stimpy think it's a good idea if they go in as fake animals. And, go in as fake animals. And, take the food. Sorry, I'm stuttering a lot because this stage is a little bit of a thinky stage. I'll try and go about it this way instead. Yeah, this is easier. Yeah, and they stop it because the zookeeper comes in. He's like, right, it's time for your real food. And it, powdered toast, man. And he comes in and what they get given is pretty much just crap in a bucket. Just like garbage, like fish eyes and stuff like that. Just slurry and nonsense. Just really stuff that isn't appetizing, you know? Come on, Stimp. There we go. Can I just... Oh, no, I gotta... Ah! Oh, hold on. Let's try this way. Let's just leap in. Whoa! Damn! Wait. There's another way. Fuck! There's gotta be a way to get in here. Gag! Okay. Oh, Stimpy managed to get in. Wait. I think... There we go. Yeah, you can change characters. And you can have different effects. On stuff like that. So the chopper... There we go, yeah. Different abilities on each character, you see. So you can do stuff like that. Oh, whoops. Well, I can't change now, I think. Or show that off. So it's to be Stimpy for now. But yeah. Different characters have different effects on their powers. Like the... You get the most height out of Stimpy's one. But... Shit! You get the most height out of Stimpy's one, but if you play... Oh, fuck. You get the most height if you use Stimpy as the propeller. But if you use Ren, you get the... You get more control of where you go. It's all about who you prefer to use. You wouldn't think a novelty game like this would have something like that. I'm only down to 2 lives and it's not looking good, really. Ah. There we go. Come on. This Avery's starting to get on my nerves. Why can't we have a normal level? There's the... Another one. Ooh, life. There we go. It's only a bit, but whatever. There we go. Good. There we go. Whew! Nasty. C plus A equals T. Yeah, absolutely. I think the next episode, I think the next level is referenced from the episode where they pretend to be fire dogs. I think for the firemen, the fire brigade, the fire officers. Well, it's in the same area, but of course they're not actually going to be Dalmatians. US mail. Come on, Powdered Toast Man. Thank you. Shit! Yeah, see, you go out of bounds, Powdered Toast Man saves you, but you get a health penalty for fucking up. Damn it. There we go. Oh. Just want to take it nice and slow. Okay, we can hop down there, good. Oh! Oh, yeah. Those suits there, those monkey suits, they are the suits they wore in that gorilla episode I was talking about. And they're like Stimpy's pajamas. The one with the fanny pack that's open. Well, they call them butt packs here, but I'll say fanny pack because that's more recognisable. You don't get clothes like that over here. It's a shame, really, because they look comfortable. And having a little pocket for you to poop out of? That sounds awesome. I'd love some little feety pajamas for adults. I know they make them because they make fucking onesies for adults that are animal themed, so I don't think it's not out of the realm of reason to imagine that they'd make them for adults as well. Little feety pajamas. No, I think I'm going backwards. Whoa. There we are. Down? Yep. 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 Oh no. Stimpy's stuck. Ah. That'll do. Wasn't the best move. Come on, Stimp, I need you on this. I need you both to be on this. There. Ah! Oh! Ooh. Come on, Stimp. Ugh. The AI is not very good, but it's pretty good for what it is. And yeah, the level does loop. I mean, I don't think it deliberately loops. I don't think we're going around in circles. I mean, they use the same asset area as they did back then. Oh yeah. Back to killing the birds on the roof. Also, I like how Stimpy has infinite noses. Very useful. Could do some health though, that would be great. The next bit's very unforgiving. Ah, US mail. Jeez. No. Okay, don't like this. I have to keep tapping A to keep the bike going to get away from the pound guy. Ah, fuck. And if you get hit, you lose lives. But it doesn't work because you still get caught, because the next stage is the pound from the pilot episode. Fuck! I only have to get to a certain bit as well, because it starts to go downhill real fast, and all I have to worry about then is jumping. Okay, here we go. Shit. Fuck. Yes, continue. God damn. All right. What's good about this game is you get infinite continues and you can keep going with the max lives that you had before, which was 4. So it's really forgiving, this game. So it like I said, this game is for Ren and Stimpy fans, mostly. And even if you're not, it's still just a fun game to play. You know, it's got a lot in it. It's not just the same thing over and over and over again. Shit! Damn it. Ah! God damn, I am bad at this. Come on, C button. I know there's a bit of a delay on you, but my word. If I can just keep this up, I think I can manage on this set of life. Ugh. Ugh. Shit. Ah! I may have to skip. At least I'm... That was pretty fun. Also, have you noticed that Horse is driving the car? I don't know his actual name, I don't remember. I think he may have a real name. Like the horse character. I just know him as Horse. Fuck! Okay, this is better. There we go. Woo! Jeez. I think that is the toughest part, apart from the last level, which is more of a fiddly platformer, really. But yeah, the rest is pretty straightforward. To the pound! From the pilot episode, where Ren and Stimpy get shoved into a pound. Yeah. Oh god. I think... Oh! God damn. Ah! Does it happen just the once? Because if so, then that makes it easier. I mean the blocks falling from the ceiling. Oh, never mind. We're here anyway. Oh god, spikes. What? Oh, do I lose health even if Stimpy loses health? Perhaps, because I do not remember getting hurt. Or did the game freak out? Did it just realize that I had zero health and was like, oh god, quick. Gotta sort that out. Yeah, this bit's a bit of annoying. Green group at the bottom, but where is it? The slight green slime that slides down the pole. There it is. You gotta kind of avoid that. Come on. Thanks, tap powdered toast man. Oh god! I had no idea that happened. Turns out if you get near the edge, you slowly inch off. The more you know. I think there's some Sonic the Hedgehog kind of ball and chain, yeah. Oh god. Oh cock, look at this. There we go. Whew. Any more? No, looks like it's free rain up here. Good. Good. One turn. Oh, I do need that. Up. Oh. Shit. Yes! Cool. Boss time. Well, it's not actually a boss, but all you gotta do is outlast them. This is a reference from the wrestling episode. It's kinda hard to keep in a. I think that's all you have to do. You have to wait for him to come to you, and then just dart to the right when he hops over you to slam his butt cheeks down. Which is also a wrestling move they used in the show. Yeah, we're just gonna make him. There we go, yeah. You just gotta outlast him and then take the piece. Ah, got a 1-up. Sweet. And I think that's almost it. One more world, the great outdoors, and then last level, and then we're done. And it's the happy, happy, joy ending. Lots of references here. The floating logs. That really gross episode where Ren has dental problems and he tries to pull out a nerve. Ooh, it's really cringy that one is. And then there's the crying eyes. I'm not sure what episode that is from. Ah, fuck. Can't tell you. Not sure if it's from the Outback episode or the episode where they're in space. Not sure. Oh. Ooh. Cool. Ugh. Wrong button each time. Yeah, and we're climbing on Stimpy's nose hair. Ah! It's very odd. This. Very odd. Ah! I think there were some falling balls at this point. Yeah. Yeah, this game's just so odd, but it's good. And there's a marmoset up there. Right, that's enough of that. Thanks. Okay. Huh. Okay, this bit. One of them spits up what you need. Like a part. And that's it. There we go. Damn it. There. Easy peasy. That's it. Last level now. We've got all the parts. There was a lot of cut content for this game as well. They were going to add so much more, but for whatever reason, they stuck to this. I don't mind. It's good what they made. Cut content, if any. Right. First of all, we've got to let a few of these bubbles get to the top. Because if you just start immediately, some of them aren't, you know, detectable, so they just don't happen. But I think now's a good time. There we go. Oh, this bit. Okay. Just fall through. No one will argue. Oh, this bit's a bit annoying. You gotta avoid the light bulbs that are turned on because they are hot. But because crap like that keeps happening, it's hard to tell when it is safe to sit on him. I'm gonna die. Oh god, I can't mess this up. Oh, Stimpy got hurt by the candlelight. Wait, what am I doing? I gotta wait. That also works, it turns out. Cool. Just fall right through. No one will ask. This though. Wait, maybe I have to change the Stimpy for this because of the shorter range of the up. Oh, you can sit on the dead pieces of light bulb, okay. Come on, I need you. Get up here. Oh, I'm gonna die. Hot damn. Yes, continue. My word, I don't remember it being this tough. Although I've not played this in a while. It turns out you can just keep doing this on the bubbles. Oh, fuck that up. I'll work this out. Done it before, I can do it again. No probs. So it turns out you can sit on the dead light bulbs. I do not remember that. Like that. I think I can just jump up there. Yes. Oh, that is much better. Good. Okay, here we are. I gotta turn all of these switches off, but the problem is that shock thing will be in the way. So I gotta time it just right to turn them all off. And some of them will turn back on, you see. But it's good. That's it. The game's done. Just turn off the machine. for some reason you've got to put it back together to turn it off or whatever. I don't know what logic it is. Cartoon video game logic, you know, don't argue. And then you get happy, happy, joy, joy credits. Well, thank you for watching. Goodbye.